हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। आई एम डॉक्टर आयुषी पालीवाल फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मॉड्यूल सेमीकंडक्टर्स फ्रॉम द पेपर नैनो फिजिक्स एट नैनो स्केल। सो द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल आर, फर्स्ट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द बैंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर्स, सेकेंडली द ब्रिलिन जोन्स, थर्डली द इफेक्टिव मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द बैंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कॉमन सेमीकंडक्टर्स, लास्टली द एब्जॉर्प्शन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर्स will be discussed. So students, let us start with a basic introduction about the module. The atom in a semiconductor are the materials from either group 4 of the periodic table or from a combination of group 3rd and group 5. They are called as third, fifth semiconductors, or of combinations from group 2nd and group 6th, called as second, sixth semiconductors. Now, because of different semiconductors, they are made up of elements from different groups. In the periodic table, the properties vary between the semiconductors. So silicon, which is a group 4, it is the most commonly used semiconductor material as it forms the basis for integrated circuits, IC chips, and is the most mature technology, and most solar cells are also silicon based. Energy band structure. When atoms are brought together in crystalline solids, the degeneracy of these energy levels are lifted due to the atomic interaction. These energy levels are extremely close to each other that they coalesce and forms an energy band. The two highest energy bands, known as valence band and conduction band, are separated by a region which is designated as forbidden band of states, which electrons cannot possess in the solid. So as you can see in this figure, the forbidden band or the forbidden energy gap is very high as in the case of insulator, whereas it is absent in the case of metals, and the forbidden energy gap for semiconductors is not too high and not too low, and it is in between as that of insulators and conductors. In the case of semiconductors, most applications, they are concerned with the states near the top of the valence band and the bottom of the conduction band. So the states in the conduction and the valence bands of semiconductors, they originate from the atomic levels of the valence shell, which are given below for most popular semiconductors. Four group of semiconductors are carbon 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, silicon 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2, and lastly we have germanium, having electronic configuration as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4P2. Next, third, fifth semiconductors are gallium arsenide, gallium 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p1 arsenide as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2 and 4p3. Next, let us discuss third, sixth semiconductors. That is cadmium selenide. So cadmium 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, 3s2, 5s2. So for selenide, we have 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p4. So the outermost atomic levels, they are either s-type or p-type. Band edges of the allowed bands of most semiconductors are at one of these points, which are high symmetry points given by gamma point, that is kx equal to 0 equal to ky equal to kz. The x point is kx equal to 2 pi by a, ky equal to kz equal to 0, and at L point, kx equal to ky equal to kz equal to pi by a, where a is a lattice constant. So the figure A shows a crystal structure of silicon, and the B part shows the Brillouin zone of silicon, and the below figure shows the band structure of silicon calculated using tight binding method. The valence band of a semiconductor is completely occupied, while the conduction band is unoccupied. However, under non-equilibrium situation, conduction band is occupied with electrons by optical excitation with an energy higher than the fundamental band gap at the expense of the creation of holes in a valence band. So the behavior of electrons and holes near the band edges determines most of the properties of semiconductors. Near the band edges, the electrons can be described by effective mass formalism, according to which the electrons behaves as if they are free inside the semiconductor crystal, except their masses are m star. So this figure shows the schematic of the valence band, the direct band gap and indirect band gap conduction bands of most of the semiconductors and different bands in valence band. Now here, as you can see, the curves first, second and third in the valence band are called as heavy hole, light hole and split off hole states respectively. The energy of the electrons at the bottom of the conduction band and the effective mass is given by, that is for a conduction band, for a direct band gap material, Eck equal to Ec0 plus h cut square k square by 2 me star, with 1 by me star equal to 1 by me plus 2 pcv the whole square divided by m square multiplied by 1 by 3 bracket multiplied by 2 by Eg gamma plus 1 by Eg gamma plus delta. So the smaller the band gap, the smaller the effective mass. Now here Me star is the mass of the electron. PCV is the momentum matrix between the conduction band and valence band. Delta is the split off energy. Now for the split off band, we have ES naught equal to minus delta minus h cut square k square by 2m star s naught and 1 by m star s naught equal to minus 1 by m plus 2 PCV square divided by 3m square Eg gamma plus delta. Now for the heavy hole and the light hole, in a simple approximation, the heavy hole and light hole bands can also be represented by the masses M H H star and M L H star. However, the real picture is more complicated. So this graph shows the dependence of the effective mass of an electron on the band gap of different 3rd, 5th and 2nd, 6th semiconductors. And as we can see from this, that the effective mass, that is Me by M naught, Me star by M naught, increases linearly with increase in the band gap in electron volts. So students, let us now discuss the band structure of silicon. Although the band structure of silicon is far from ideal, having an indirect band gap, the big hole masses and small spin orbit splitting processing related advantages makes silicon the premier semiconductor for consumer electronics. On the right, we show the constant energy ellipsoids for the silicon conduction band. And as you can see over here, that there are 6 equivalent valleys in silicon at the conduction band edge. On the left hand side, we can see the variation of the energy with the propagation constant K, and there is the energy band gap Eg, which is equal to 1.1 electron volt at 300 Kelvin. Now Eg is equal to 1.17 minus 4.37 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4 T square by T minus 636 electron volts, where T is the temperature in Kelvin. Indirect band gap material corresponds to weak optical transmission, that is, it cannot be used to produce lasers. So the valleys along the x-axis and the negative x-axis, that is k naught x equal to 2 pi by a multiplied by 0.8500, and the k naught x on the negative side is equal to 2 pi by a minus 0.8500. So the energy as a function of K is equal to Ec plus h cut square by 2 multiplied by square bracket Kx minus K naught x द होल स्क्वायर बाय एम एल स्टार प्लस के एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस के जेड स्क्वायर बाय एम टी स्टार, वेयर एम एल इज 0.98 एम नॉट एंड एम टी इज 0.19 एम नॉट. सिमिलरली ई के रिलेशंस आर वैलिड फॉर अदर फोर वैलीज. सो द डेंसिटी ऑफ स्टेट्स वेयर मास इक्वल टू 1.08 एम नॉट, दैट इज इट इंक्लूड्स 6 वैलीज. नाउ द हैवी होल मास विच इज अराउंड 0.49 एम नॉट एंड द लाइट होल मास विच इज अराउंड 0.16 एम नॉट. लास्टली द इंट्रिंसिक कैरियर कंसंट्रेशन एट 300 केल्विन इज अराउंड 1.5 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 10 टू द पावर सेंटीमीटर माइनस 3. सो लेट अस नाउ डिस्कस द बैंड गैप ऑफ गैलियम आर्सेनाइड एट 0 केल्विन इज 1.51 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट एंड एट 300 केल्विन इट इज 1.43 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. So here the bottom of the conduction band is at K equal to 000, that is the G point, and the upper conduction band valleys are at the L point. So the energy band gap for gallium arsenide is around 1.43 electron volt at 300 Kelvin. And the expression for the temperature dependent band gap is Eg equal to 1.519 minus 5.4 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4 T square by T plus 204 electron volt, where T is the temperature in Kelvin. So students, let us discuss some of the main features of conduction band and valence band. Let us first discuss the conduction band. The electron mass is light, that is, it is around m star equal to 0.067 m naught. The upper valley mass is large, that is, m star equal to 0.25 m naught. It results in the negative differential resistance at higher fields. The material in direct band gap and has strong optical transmission implies that it can be used for light emission. Next is a valence band. So here the heavy hole mass is around 0.45 m naught. Light hole mass is around 0.08 m naught, and the intrinsic carrier concentration at 300 Kelvin equal to 1.84 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 centimeter minus 3. So now these are the graphs showing the band structure of germanium. The germanium band gap is around 0.66 electron volt at 300 Kelvin. Another, the next graph shows the band structure of aluminium arsenide, having the energy band gap around 2.15 electron volt at 300 Kelvin. The next shows the band structure of indium arsenide, having the energy band gap of around 0.35 electron volt at 300 Kelvin. And the next shows the band structure of indium phosphide, having the energy band gap of around 1.34 electron volt at 300 Kelvin. So students, let us discuss the absorption coefficient for some semiconductor materials. Different semiconductor materials, they have different absorption coefficients. So the materials with higher absorption coefficients, they more readily absorb the photons, which excite the electrons into the conduction band. So knowing the absorption coefficients of the materials aids the engineers in determining which material to use in their solar cell designs. So the absorption coefficient basically determines how far into the material light of a particular wavelength can penetrate before it is absorbed. So in a material with low absorption coefficient, light is only poorly absorbed. And if the material is thin enough, it will appear transparent to that wavelength. So the absorption coefficient depends on the material and also on the wavelength of the light which is being absorbed. So semiconductor materials, they have a sharp edge in their absorption coefficient, since the light which has energy below the band gap does not have sufficient energy to excite an electron into the conduction band from the valence band. Consequently, this light is not absorbed. The absorption coefficient for several semiconductor materials is shown below. So here the above graph shows that even for those photons which have an energy above the band gap, the absorption coefficient is not constant, but still it depends strongly on the wavelength. So the probability of absorbing a photon depends on the likelihood of having a photon and an electron interact in such a way as to move from one energy band to another. So for the photons which have an energy very close to that of the band gap, the absorption is relatively low, since only those electrons directly at the valence band edge can interact with the photon to cause the absorption. As the photon energy increases, not just the electrons already having energy close to that of the band gap can interact with the photon. Therefore, a large number of electrons can interact with the photon and result in the photon being absorbed. Evolution of energy levels. So as it is shown in this figure, that the energy difference between a ground state and an excited state in an atom, equivalently energy difference between the highest occupied molecular orbital, that is HOMO, and lowest unoccupied orbital, LUMO, and the energy difference between the valence band and the conduction band in a nanoparticle and bulk solid are the most important energy scales. So this energy difference decreases as we go from atom to molecule, then to a nanoparticle, and then to a bulk. Cadmium selenide nanoparticles, colloids with different particle size. Now students, the color of the emitted light from different systems depends on the size of the system. So transition energy being maximum in an atom, then molecule and then bulk. The transition energy in a nanoparticle is intermediate between a molecule and bulk solid. So this intermediate range can be extended from visible to infrared by varying the size of nanoparticle. So as evident from this figure, where the part A shows us the photoluminescence spectra of cadmium selenide nanoparticle colloidal solutions with decreasing particle size, and the B shows the schematic representation of size, color, and the peak positions in photoluminescence spectra of the cadmium selenide nanoparticles. The C shows the absorption and photoluminescence spectra of cadmium selenide nanoparticles. The quantum confinement in semiconductor nanoparticles. Now, for an electron confined in a box, the kinetic energy of the electron increases as the size of the box gets smaller. So this is the manifestation of uncertainty relation, that is delta x delta p is approximately equal to h cut. If we assume the size of the box L equal to delta x and electron momentum p is equal to mv, the minimum kinetic energy can be given by E equal to h cut square by 2ml square, where h cut is a Planck's constant and m is the electron mass. So this expression is the basic principle behind the effect of size on the color of semiconductor nanoparticle, which is a small semiconductor box, and therefore the band gap between the valence band and the empty state increases as the box gets smaller. This is schematically shown in this figure. Now, using this equation, which uses the free electron mass m, hence we would predict very small effect of box size on the semiconductor band gap at the nanometer scale. So here the problem is the use of free electron mass. However, as discussed before, in crystalline solids, electron mass has to be replaced by effective mass m star. Let us say, for an example, in indium arsenide, the effective mass is 0.023 times as that of the free electron mass. So smaller the mass makes the semiconductor material much more sensitive to the size of the box at the nanometer scale. Types of nanoparticles or quantum dots. So the basic purpose of any semiconductor based nanostructure is to confine the electrons and the holes in a potential well, so that their energy is less in the surrounding matrix compared to that in the confined structure. Such a potential well in a confined structure can be achieved by various architectures. So the most popular and well investigated three different types of architectures for nanoparticles are shown in this figure. The first type is colloidal semiconductor nanoparticles, which are synthesized by wet chemical process. The confined potential for electrons and holes is created by surrounding solvent. So typical examples are group 2nd, 6th and 3rd, 5th semiconductors. So here the colloidal cadmium telluride nanoparticle in dispersion are shown. The organic ligands at the surface of the nanoparticle forms an intermediate energy barrier. So the second type is embedded nanoparticle grown by different epitaxial methods. In this case, the confined potential for electrons and holes is created by surrounding semiconductor material with the higher band gap. A typical example of such a system is the group 3rd, 5th semiconductors with the low band gap embedded in a matrix of another 3rd, 5th semiconductor with higher band gap. Next, the third type is based on electrically confined potential affected by an electric field in two-dimensional electron gas at the interface in the semiconductor heterostructure. So typical example is 2D electron gas that is formed at the interface between a gallium arsenide, aluminium gallium arsenide heterostructure. So the zero-dimensional potential confinement is achieved by applying a negative potential to metal gate electrodes that are deposited on the top of the 2D electron gas. Electronic structure of semiconductor nanoparticles. The electronic structure of semiconductor nanoparticles strongly depends on the size due to quantum confinement, which can be understood in two different approaches. In the first approach, known as top-down method, the nanoparticles, they can be treated as a small piece of bulk, three-dimensional semiconductor crystal, and electronic structure can be calculated by extending the band structure calculations employed for the bulk crystal with appropriate boundary conditions. But in the second approach, known as bottom-up method, nanoparticles, they can be considered as giant molecule built up by atom by atom, and electronic structure is calculated by quantum mechanical approach, generally used for calculating the electronic structure for molecules. So students, let us summarize what we have learnt in this module. First, the energy band gap of materials has been discussed. Secondly, the band structure of semiconductors has been discussed in detail. Thirdly, the direct and indirect band gap semiconductors have been classified. Lastly, or we can say that the effective mass of electrons for semiconductors has been calculated, and the absorption coefficient of semiconductors was also discussed. we discussed about the semiconductor nanoparticles also, and the basic purpose of semiconductor based nanostructure is to confine the electrons in a potential well so that the energy is less in the surrounding matrix compared to that in the confined matrix. So, here a brief discussion about the electronic structure of semiconductor nanoparticles, which strongly depends on the size, was also discussed. Thank you.